perspective, I said, if you call it Venezuela, was that we are exporting both the export proceeds and the product. I even said that in my school of economics, I was told that we talk about GDP, we talk about the product, and we plus exports but as imports. Now here we are also exporting the currency. So this is the way where I want to combine with my colleague who just asked. So we're talking about foreign currency, which are talking about. If you look at Botswana, for example, more than 75% of their revenue comes from diamonds. And if you look at their fiscals, most of their budget comes from the diamond sector. Their exports, more than 80% of their exports are diamond. So you can see the impact of diamond into the Botswana economy. If you look at Namibia, 50% of the sales of diamonds go to Botswana, sorry, Namibian government fiscals. But if you look at Zimbabwe, 2.5% of the sales is ZMTC management fee. It's only 15% of the royalty fees that goes to fiscals. How then do you compare the balance between the two, the regional and ourselves? When you try to increase the royalty dividend, which is called dividend, by 15%, there was resistance from this economy, from the people who are in government. It was defense by the minister. This is what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about how they mind. I'm just saying, it's very important that we have a fair share of that diamonds. That's why I say, we do not grow diamonds here. They are a depletable resource. This is where we agree, undermining. That is, then why do you need foreign investors undermining? For example, the side talk about diamonds here. I'm not talking about smelting government. No, I'm talking about the extraction of a stone which is not being manufactured. It's easier to dig diamonds as from which they are using diamonds than to grow maize. Yes, I can go that I can tell you. We come from that area. When Zimbabweans were, before there was organized companies that are producing diamonds right now, Zimbabwe had more impact. There was more impact of those diamonds coming from these peaks and shadows. You're forgotten. You're forgotten. When this is not so we need to go ahead. It shows that this economy is leaking. It means that there are loopholes which are changing to cross. Because even if you are going to, yes, we love Dima, we are involved in that. But why are we saying this? Because if you still have loopholes, when you are going to borrow money from IMF, KGB, World Bank, as long as the loopholes are there, the money will also go out again. Mm. And that's the point, you need to close those loopholes first and foremost. Mm. Before you just go, and you can go and go and call the money $20 billion today, until in a dollarized economy, because the dollar which is in Zimbabwe, the same dollar which is in America, the same dollar which is in Namibia, there are also temptations. Zimbabwe becomes an arbitrage economy. Yes. Therefore, we need to close those arbitrage loopholes at this point. Mm-hmm. This is what I'm talking about. So we need to, therefore, don't confuse the process of selling and talk about utilizing resources. Then the second one, that's why, as I said, mining. Mining, there are two sides of mining. There's mining that is just pure extraction. There's mining that is expansion in terms of smelting, like Zimbabwe, that's something else. But as long as you're mining, you come to Zimbabwe, those products, if you, as I said before, coal is under the ground, or what you need is to hammer it by the jackhammers. You need all those excavators take out, wash and go away. Therefore, you need Zimbabwe, throughout the whole world, if you've noticed, you need Zimbabwe to ensure that we retain some of the foreign exchange that we're earning from our minerals in Zimbabwe. In fact, I'm even wondering whether there was under CMDC and this gold, this diamond mine, where there's 50-50, but if it was 50-50, why can't you also say this is the rich and that of the other 50%? Why does the other 50% get richer than the other? This is what I'm talking about here. I'm talking about transparency. We need to work up the smell of the coffee. We are losing money there. And that money can help us buy our maize, which I'm talking about. Can buy everything if you're organized. So I'm talking about, that's why I see more opportunities, because I see organization. Yes, the families, the organization. I think they don't think that to be very careful. I think it's because Zimbabwe is with the perception that what is happening by government, they should end the wrong. I don't belong to that category. We've done some introspection. This my friend is my brother. I think he voted this one more in there. I gave a good example. In fact, it's there, if you look at the first part, there are two pathways. First pathway says that you can use the lesser share of indigenization, which are lesser share of 51%. Meaning that you can use your quotas and your credits. And if you manufacture a sector, which is the domain, the guidelines of the Gazette says up to 31% can be attained by using the socially and economically desirable objectives, which is the value addition, which is the line of demand, which is employment, which is a major problem in the economy, which in the transfer of technology, which is what one is going, 31%. So if you have 31% plus 49% shall out, it's 80%. You have to go left to 20%. We shall not say 20%. If you don't want to comply, you pay a small value for that. 20% of the whatever level, the percentage, so it can't be 100%. It's 20%. So it means that says you are if you comply 100%. And you can also get the membership schemes. If you have a part of your assets, you want to give them 5% or 10%? I think that's also wrong. So to me, yeah, they're very fair. That's why I say the left person in the room is only the 11. And this is the discourse that we need to continue to have in this discussion until there's a special instrument. Because right now, it's a notice. It's an intention where government is going. Let's maximize this to advocacy. Then talk to Minister, who is here? And Minister, can you please reduce your appetite from 10 maybe to 0? That's Minister's prerogative. And then the Minister now goes to the Minister of Finance. And this process goes to Minister of Finance, put it this 11, goes to Minister of Finance, then cabinet, then to the Parliament. That's how they are done. Now we have got the time. And that's if you complain now at 10% too high, and then any day, without making the misunderstanding what you are asking for, and you make a mistake. So that's just to me, this is very clear. But those organs are afraid of doing the right things. And then the last one, is the one. The president, before he was speaking here, because of his life, talk about the one, about the current situation. Let me make it clear. To Switzerland and those who care to listen. That in currencies we have two types of issues. Over what we call the settlement currency, they are trading currencies. In Zimbabwe, we are using a multi-currency system, whereby the US dollar is the settlement currency. The other currencies are trading currencies. That's not the end basket. That's why your rand, your pound, your yuan, your Botswana pula, Japanese yen, Kenyan dollar, all those outline, they are in the basket of currencies that are used for trading. That's why you can trade with the rand. That's why when you are paying euro, you pay euro, you are paying euro. That's trading. That's why you pay in a pound, you're also trading. What we were saying, which has been spotted, it did not be spotted, but others are just as usual, they want to go in panic mode. In some ways, they're also very funny. You're every day you're all going in panic mode, and you want to develop. You can't develop in a panic mode, by the way. So, the yuan, what we say is, just like the rand, the trade between Zimbabwe and China is high. Most of these base stations you see, they're from China.